Good afternoon, students. Today's topic is the primary healthcare. The primary healthcare definition says that it is essential healthcare. Okay, it is very essential. It is very important healthcare. It is made universally accessible to individual. Like how it is made, like it is accessible. It is reachable to everybody in the universal. Okay, it is reachable to the all the persons. And acceptable to them, and all people in the community that accepted this health care through their full participation. Okay, they are participated well and they are appreciated this health care, and it is very universally reachable to the all and everybody. So participation and at a cost the community and country can afford. This is about the primary health care. Now we'll see the characteristics of primary healthcare. It is cost effective healthcare. Nowadays the all health facilities are become very so expensive. Okay, and when we see in the community area, the poverty line is very high. That's what they are not affording the proper health facilities. That's what the main aim of this primary healthcare is: cost effective healthcare facilities to the community people. We'll see the nature of primary healthcare. Mainly there is a preventive nature, in the sense we need to prevent the people from getting any type of disease conditions by proper health education, immunization by all means, and promotive measures like the promotion of their health. Okay, and the curative measures, in the sense cure of the disease, proper treatment, so that we can cure a person from any type of disease conditions. Rehabilitation, okay, if the person is become injured or his extremities become damaged, okay, proper rehabilitation, in the sense giving some kind of artificial limbs, okay, proper rehabilitation for the psychiatric patients. Okay, these all things comes under primary healthcare. Next, we'll see the elements of primary healthcare. Education concerning prevailing health problems and the methods of preventing and controlling. The main element of this primary healthcare is to educate the people. Okay, proper education is needed the community people regarding how we can prevent the health problems and which are the methods to prevent them and control them. This is how they can improve their health quality in the community area. The next is promotion of food and food supply and proper nutrition. The food supply or the proper nutrition is very much essential elements in the primary healthcare, as the nutrition plays very important role in the maintaining of the health condition. That's what the nutrition plate is very much important to maintain the health. So if there is any malnutrition, if the person is not getting not proper nutrition, the person may go for any type of nutrition related disease conditions, or it directly affect the health of the patient. That's what the nutrition is very much important, and it is provided in under the primary health care scheme. Next one is an adequate supply of safe water and the basic sanitation. The water is major source for disease conditions. The uncontaminated water which causes a lot of disease conditions. Okay, so it is very dangerous. That's what the safe water supply should be there. Okay, which is conducted by the primary health care. It is one of the important aim, okay, to maintain the health of the individual in the community area. So the proper and safe water supply should be there, and basic sanitation. Due to unhygienic sanitary conditions, okay, there are lot of disease conditions to get born, like vector-borne diseases, any type of communicable diseases, skin disease. Okay, that's what the sanitation should be maintained in a well manner. That's what we can prevent the occurring of the disease condition. That's what the sanitation is very much important. Next one is maternal and child health care, including family planning. Maternal care in the sense antenatal care as well as postnatal care. Antenatal care includes the proper antenatal checkups and iron and folic acid tablet distribution. Along with that, the proper health education to the mothers and exercises, okay, screening in a regular time intervals. When we see in the postnatal mothers, the proper breastfeeding techniques which should be taught to the mothers. Proper diet, importance of the nutrition in the postnatal mothers because they are feeding the babies, and child health care. Child health care includes the under 5 children who are very vulnerable for disease condition because they are lower immunity. So the child health care includes the proper nutrition, okay, immunization program to the children. Okay, these all comes under maternal and child health care. Family planning. Family planning is very much important to prevent the increasing population growth. So family planning, there are two types, lobectomy and vasectomy. Family planning methods are very important in the primary healthcare concept. Appropriate treatment of common diseases and injuries. The primary care consists of the minor elements or common diseases or injuries. That's what we can call it the primary healthcare. So the primary healthcare provides appropriate treatment to the common diseases like cough, cold, fever, any type of minor ailments and injuries like a minor dressings, suture removals, suturings. Okay, these all the work done under the primary healthcare concept. Provision of essential drugs. Okay, essential drugs in the sense. Anti-tuberculosis drug, anti-retroviral drugs, okay. So chemotherapy drugs. These are the some essential drugs. These are the drugs supplied by the government, which is cost effective. Next, we'll see the principles of primary healthcare. Okay, there are mainly 5 types of principles. The first one is equitable distribution. The community participation, intersectoral coordination, appropriate technology, and prevention. Equitable distribution in the sense, the health services must be shared equally by all people irrespective of their ability to pay. Equitable distribution in the sense, the health services will be provided to the all the people in the universe regarding their age, their poverty level, the rural level, the urban, okay, whether okay, instead of all these things, the health is supplied throughout the universe to the all the people. Okay, there is no partiality in delivering the healthcare facilities. Okay, it is equally distributed to the community people, regardless their age, gender, race, their poverty, their caste, their religion, their country. Okay, regardless these all things, the health services are distributed or delivered equally to the people. Community participation. Involvement of the individual and the community in promotion of their health, their own health and welfare is an essential ingredient of a primary health care. Okay, the community people has to participate. Okay, without their participation, the program will not succeed or fulfilled. Okay, why? Because the function is gathered to improve their own health. That's what the community member has to participate to improve their health conditions. Next one is intersectoral coordination. There is an increasing realization that HFA cannot be provided. Health for all cannot be provided by the health sector alone. Okay, only the thing is the doctor cannot treat the patient alone. Okay, to improve the patient condition. Okay, the patient needs the doctor, the nurse, the technicians, and physiotherapists, dietitians. Okay, the collaborative care will enhance or will provide the comprehensive care to the patient. Okay, it will improve their health condition. Okay, that's what the intersectoral coordination or the collaborative patient care is very important. Okay, the care will be not delivered alone. Okay, so to improve the patient condition, to improve the patient health, okay, to decrease the patient disease, the intersectoral coordination is very much important. Next one is appropriate technology. Appropriate technology has been defined as a technology that is scientifically sound, adaptable to local needs, and acceptable to those who apply it. Okay, when we can say the technology, scientific technology or appropriate technology, the technology, it has to be proved by the scientific sources. Okay, there is a scientific reason behind that technology. Okay, it should be witnessed by the scientific proofs. Adaptable to local needs. Okay, that technology will be suitable. It should suit to the community area or the local needs. Acceptable to those who apply it. The people need to accept that, the one who will use them. That when then that we can say the appropriate technology. And for those whom it is used, and the gap be maintained by the people themselves, to keeping with the principles of self-reliance with the resources the community and country can afford. So these are some principles, basic principles. These are the very much important principles, and which explains everything about the primary healthcare. Like, what is the main concept? It focuses directly on the concept of the primary healthcare. What it is the primary healthcare? How we will provide? Okay, so these are the principles of primary healthcare. So this is regarding primary healthcare and elements of primary healthcare and principles of the primary healthcare.